Today's video is sponsored by Surfshark.
Hey, it's me, Katie. Welcome back to Spill the Spotlight. Today I'm even more excited than usual because I have been dying to film this video for the longest time. I was kind of putting it off because I figured that you guys more so enjoyed like overall anime videos where you get bits of your different favorite shows. But you know what? This is one of the most stylish animes in history and it deserves its own moment, so here we have it, a dedicated Nana inspired lookbook. But even if you haven't seen the show, if you're just generally a fan of fashion, I'm sure you still walk away with a little bit of outfit inspo. And if you haven't seen the anime, please add it to your to watch list immediately.
I don't know why, but it almost felt criminal to start out with anyone other than Nana Osaki, so here we are with probably the most recreated look of the entire series. But for good reason, there is nothing wrong with the classics. The three main elements are the thigh-high stockings, the plaid skirt, and the leopard coat. Other than that, you can kind of play around with what you have in your wardrobe. I decided to go with this white lace undershirt teamed with a corset, but I think I almost prefer it undone. I don't know, something about the lines it creates just looks more visually interesting to me. But yeah, overall, I am just so in love with this look. It is easily recognizable without feeling too costumey, and there's just something about Ayuzawa's character designs in general that feel really timeless. The looks weren't bogged down in trends, they really had personal style to them, meaning that it doesn't matter what year you recreate these, you're always gonna look stylish. Okay, where are all the Yasu stands at? I know you're out there, and I just wanna say congratulations on being the intellectuals of the Nana fandom. You really carry the rest of us on your back. You know, what can I say? Some of us just enjoy the pain and suffering. His style is very clean, simple, sophisticated, very classic once again. I mostly stuck to an all black color palette, just adding in a little bit more pizzazz than was probably necessary, but I was kind of trying to go for more of a stage performance outfit, so we're sticking true to his personal style, but almost as though the blast stylist was trying to elevate the look just a little bit with the silver stripe through the blazer and a couple more accessories than he might usually go for. What do you guys think? I feel like Shin is probably one of the most lovable characters of the series, and I just feel so bad for him. Not even just with the Reira stuff, but I feel like even his own bandmates don't really look out for him. And I love the storyline when Hachi's maternal instincts kind of kick in and she's really there for him, but it is a little bit too late. I don't know, I could literally talk about Nana characters forever, so feel free to leave your thoughts and opinions in the comments. Obviously, he has such a cool style as well. Two of the main things that I associate him with is plaid pants and also the bondage pants with all of the straps. Unfortunately, I don't have a pair, so I had to go with the plaid ones, and then to spice it up a little bit, I added this kind of half wraparound skirt situation, which I think he would rock the hell out of. Let's not talk about the fact that I do not have the orb lighter necklace because it haunts me at night. Those things are so expensive and so hard to come by. Maybe one day, but for now, I did recently purchase this Vivian Westwood pin, which you may have noticed I am wearing in every outfit, because what is a Black Stones look without a little bit of Vivian Westwood, my friends? All right, to round out the Blast members, we have my boy Nobu. I'm not saying he's done no wrong, but I am saying I am willing to overlook it, okay? He has a very special place in my heart. But when it comes to his style, I feel like he kind of takes inspiration from a few of the other characters and then makes it his own. One of the easiest ways to tell if it's a Nobu fit is if white creepers are involved, okay? Those are the key. I love how this outfit turned out. The asymmetrical suspender pants are just so cool to me. And also this plaid vest, totally interchangeable for a blazer though, if that's what you have. Introducing a subtle pattern clash with these stripe arm warmers, I think, is a really nice touch too. The only thing I'm kind of iffy on is the beret, just because it makes the top of my head look disproportionately large for some reason. But that's kind of on brand, like Nobu's head is kind of drawn like that. Also, just quickly for the fellow K-pop stans watching, I could totally see someone like Hongjung from 80s or Bomgyu from TXT wearing this outfit, which makes me love it even more.
Just me popping in with a little PSA, if you will, that if you are looking for more anime to binge watch, but you feel like you've exhausted all your options on your Netflix already, then today's video sponsor might be a good match for you. It is award-winning VPN Surfshark. So the version of Netflix you're seeing can be completely different to someone on the other side of the world, but with Surfshark, you're able to quickly and easily change those location settings and instantly have access to a ton more content. If you're here, I'm thinking you're probably an anime fan. If so, trust me, you're going to want to head over to either Singapore or Thailand. They have way more to choose from and they still have English subtitle options. And the amazing thing about Surfshark is that they actually offer unlimited devices under just one account. So everyone you share your Netflix with can get in on the action and find the perfect location for their specific taste. And on top of that, you'll also be ensuring your privacy and safety online because Surfshark protect all of your personal information. So you can use my code SPOTLIGHT for 83% off plus 3 extra months for free. And since Surfshark offer a 30-day money-back guarantee, you can try it all risk-free via the link on screen and down below in the description box.
It's time for a bit of Trap Nest inspo now, and I know there's a lot of Rayra aunties out there. I get it. I hear you. I understand where you're coming from, but I cannot deny the fact that she is very, very pretty, and I think this outfit would suit her perfectly, either for a stage performance or like an album concept photo shoot. Instantly for her, I knew I wanted to go for a maxi length, and I actually ended up layering two just because I like that it brings a little bit more dynamic to the look without actually having to wear an outerwear piece. And then since that leaves our arms bare, I was able to really showcase these beautiful lace sleeves. Despite the fact that I'm here alone for some reason, I feel like I'm being held against my will and forced to do a Takumi inspired look, but it kind of had to be done. So here it is. Of course, it's very simple. His is probably one of the easiest to recreate. It's just all black. We've got some leather action happening, a button down, and I did switch out from my usual chunky boots to something a little bit more sleek. His styling, and to a certain degree, Trap Nest in general, does feel a little bit more polished. Obviously, they don't have those same punk roots as Blast. They're more of like a pop rock group that has more money behind them as well, so I do think it makes sense. Before we move on, I need you to know that this is a safe place for Takumi slander, okay? I encourage it, in fact, because this man makes my blood boil. Moving on to my favorite underrated member of Trap Nest, Naoki. I just think he has such a fun energy, definitely had the potential to be great besties with Hachiko. Like, I love the scenes when they are together. His style kind of infuses a bit of a retro 70s flair to it, which I tried to embrace with the skinny scarf, the fitted vest, and of course, the tinted sunglasses. I chose to go for a purple shirt, not just because I think we see him in this color a bit during the anime, but also because I kind of wanted all of Trap Nest to match in together, and Rayra had a little bit of purple in her outfit as well. I feel like Ren would potentially find himself in those TikTok videos that are like, is it a fit or is he just skinny? Because he is shirtless more often than he needs to be, and usually it's teamed with skinny jeans and a leather jacket as well. So of course, that's what we had to do here, although it's not really my typical style. I tried to spice up the jeans a little bit with some safety pin accents and a harness, as well as layering my boots over the top. The real tragedy of this look is that I didn't have a padlock necklace. Like, it's not a Ren outfit without one, but I had to opt for this like handcuff chain that I had instead. That was the closest thing I could come by in my collection. Surprisingly, I am serving you back-to-back Ren looks. I wanted to try and experiment with something a little bit more fun for him rather than just what he typically wears on stage. It's definitely giving me like a long distance truck driver energy, but I do actually think that strangely works for him. I could totally see this Harley Davidson cutoff vest in his casual wardrobe along with the jeans and also a good old cap. Oh, which by the way, if you guys are wondering where any of the items are from, I'm gonna have everything listed in the description box, so make sure you check that out. Of course, who is Ren without Nana? So I decided to do another more casual look for her too. And you might be thinking this one isn't like super stereotypical of her, but it is actually directly inspired by a particular outfit we see her in. To me, this would be perfect if you really admire her style, but it's not what you usually wear. This is like a great little stepping stone to try it out. And then on the other hand, if this version is a little bit too cutesy for you, all you have to do is get rid of the cardigan and switch it out for an outerwear piece more in line with your personal style. I promise there's more characters coming up, but for now, here's another Yasu look. Again, just wanted to show you a more casual option for him too. I'm obsessed with this oversized blazer. Like, this is my favorite thing. It is crazy how much just that one denim sleeve can add to the fit. The rest stays super simple, all black. Of course, gotta have his signature beanie and glasses combo to finish it off. I know she's not in the show for long, but of course I had to do Queen Mew. I actually really like her. Her style is kind of hard to pinpoint, though she's a bit of a chameleon. Like, you could show me a picture of her in just about anything and I'd be like, yep, sounds about right. So what I mostly decided to take inspo from was her around the dorms, because she definitely keeps it very comfortable and casual with a lot of knitwear, sweatshirts, hoodies, that sort of thing, but she still looks really cute. I thought this color palette would be really nice on her and kind of reflects her more soft-spoken nature as well. I accessorized with some leg warmers because I felt like that was what was missing in this video thus far. We do see a few of the characters wearing them. And then to kind of balance that out and also bring just the block colors together, I threw on this striped scarf. It only made sense to do the other dorm GF as well, so here we have Yuri. She kind of has like a popular 2000s gal vibe going on. So immediately I knew I wanted to style this denim skirt, and I thought that playing around with more lingerie inspired pieces would be perfect for her. And I gotta say, out of the bunch, I feel like this one feels the most relevant, currently trendy today in 2021 as well. But to finish it off, I ended up throwing on this faux fur jacket. If I'm not mistaken, I believe she wears one in the manga. I had to do everyone's favorite, most successful fangirl initially introduced to us as Misato. She has such a cute style, very like Lolita-esque. Sadly, since that is such a specific aesthetic and something that I don't personally have in my wardrobe, it was kind of hard to recreate, but I have done my best and I actually really like how it turned out. I mean, ideally, I would have preferred a red color palette rather than purple for Misato, but this is the only dress I had in this sort of silhouette, which was left over from my Monster High lookbook. Okay, let me know if you guys have this sort of problem as well. It's pretty much choking. I love Shin's style, it's one of my favorites, but for some reason when I had to come up with outfits for him, I just couldn't quite make it work. Like, something just feels off about it. I don't know, I feel like the bagginess just isn't suiting me. I also think that his hair plays a big role in his look as well. Like, imagine if he kept his hairstyle from the beginning of the show throughout the entire thing. Like, none of his outfits would have gone as hard, which I feel like is potentially what's happening here, but I don't know, it has so many of the key elements he would enjoy, but something just isn't quite clicking. Did you peep the white creepers? Of course, that means we're back with another Nobu look. I feel like out of the Black Stones members, he's the best at pulling off casual because he has these really nice slouchy knitwear options and then some really cool jeans as well. I actually purchased these ones because they reminded me of him. I don't know, something about the wash and the zipper placement. The longer sweater with a low rise belt teamed over the top isn't something I would typically gravitate towards just because I wouldn't think it would be flattering, but I actually ended up really enjoying it for some reason, so that was a nice surprise. Immediately, you gotta know that I do not like to see any Hachi slander. I am a bit of a Hachi kinny myself, which is probably why I'm so defensive. Don't get me wrong, she has a lot of flaws and makes a lot of mistakes, which should be discussed, but I just feel like sometimes the commentary is a little bit unfairly negative and also biased because people seem to forget that literally every character in this series is flawed. That's part of what makes it so great and so realistic. So I guess it just kind of confuses me when I see people shit on Hachi, but then almost put Nana Osaki on some sort of pedestal because she has her toxic traits too. So pretty much just keep the same energy for everyone. My apologies for the rant and not talking about the outfit, but I had to get that off my chest. Obviously, Hachi's wardrobe has more of a sweet, soft girl energy to it. The frill detailing on this coat was screaming Hachi to me. It's definitely the star of the show in this first look, but the second look is actually my preferred option. I love the pink and green color combo grounded with these more neutral accessories. And the structured blazer is just an A+ in my books. Like, this is one of those rare times where I feel like patting myself on the back. This is a job well done. Wow. The audacity I had to not only include Shoji in this video, but then to also give him a great fit. Like, what was I thinking? I feel like it's definitely working hard to hit the brief of art student about to gaslight you, and Shoji might just be the most realistic character of the entire series. Unfortunately, I feel like a lot of us have met someone very similar to him. I hope you weren't actually sitting there thinking I was about to leave Junko out of this. Come on now, I could never. I find her style to be very refreshing because it is just more effortless and a little bit more relaxed. And in my heart, I just know she would own these pants. I decided to throw in a second look for her last minute because, again, she would own this jacket. This jacket is in her wardrobe 100%. It's giving very Bratz Express It collection, but by teaming it with this skirt, it almost mixes in a little more of a boho element too. I feel like I've spoken for way too long in this video, but at the same time, I still have so much left to say, so please feel free to join me in the comments. We can discuss your favorite style icons from this series, your favorite characters, just any thoughts and feelings. Nana discourse is always open for business on this channel. If you're looking for more anime fashion content, make sure you subscribe, but also check me out over on TikTok because I'm posting way more frequently over there now. But yeah, thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed and I'll see you around soon. Bye.